Hey everyone, I'm Rick Beato. On today's Everything Music, it's What Makes This Song Great, episode 73. The band is the Rolling Stones and the song is Angie, coming up next. For any of you that have been watching this channel for a while, you've heard me mention the fact that Angie is my favorite song of all time. I bought the single when it came out. It was off the record Goat's Head Soup. From the intro guitar part to the beautiful piano accompaniment played by Nicky Hopkins, the lyrics, the melody, it's just a killer song. String arrangement, drums and bass. Let's check out the intro. I brought in a couple friends of mine to do it before we get to the actual track. My piano player here, Jez Graham. I wanted to talk a little bit about the keyboardist, the pianist that played on the track originally, Nicky Hopkins. Love Jez, you want to talk about him?
Nicky's so important in rock music. He played on, I mean, how many other piano players played with the Beatles, the Stones, the Kinks, Jeff Beck Group, and he made some really good solo albums also. But, you know, he just knew how to play the right part to make the song sing, you know, to just make the song come alive.
Let's talk for a second about the chord progression because it's very unique. He starts out with a harmonic here on the A string and then he puts that pinky in there, becomes an A minor 7 for a second. Then he goes here. Now that's an E7 chord, but you wouldn't typically play it like that. And then he puts that third in the bass. That's an E7 over G sharp. I had never seen that chord before. I figured it out by ear. But then here. So he's got a G sus 4 chord, G suspended 4, that doesn't resolve. Then he goes down to F sus 4. Right there is a key change because these two chords are really, you know, G major. You have that chromatic line built right in there. Then he's using C sus 4 to C, and then it's a G over B, and then back to A minor. So that whole chord sequence is very unusual and really melodic. I want to talk about what's going on the recording during that, because there's some really interesting things using the reverb between the acoustic guitar and the piano. Let's check that out. If we take it from the top, you'll notice the acoustic guitar is panned into the left speaker. Check it out. Now in the right speaker is the reverb. Here's both together. Then when the piano comes in, that comes in the other speaker. Listen. That is a way that they used to make things stereo and fill up the stereo spectrum. You have the acoustic in one speaker and the reverb for that acoustic in the other. Then you have the piano comes in and they put the reverb from that, from the piano's in the right speaker and the reverb's in the left speaker, and it really fills up the stereo image and sounds really rich and beautiful. It's almost like having a pad like a keyboard pad on each side filling in the stereo field.
Let's talk about the melody next. So Mick comes in with a... And then in the space, Keith fills. And then... And then the piano does its fill. And then... When will those... He's singing the D on the G chord. When will those clouds all... And that's so beautiful because on that you have... Between the suspension on the F sus 4 to the F, the voice is going, and the guitar is going. So you've got, disappear. And again there, you have a dissonance, you have that C sus chord, and Mick is singing the D on it. So you've got all these beautiful suspensions on top of one another that are happening that just... That's where that chill factor comes in. You get chills on those kind of melody lines, all those little distances. Now, did they know what they were doing? No, but they both have an incredibly great ability to come up with beautiful melodies that work perfectly with the chord progressions. Next, I want to talk about the lyrics of the song, and I brought my friend Shane Lee in. Shane was singing here at the top of the song, but Shane actually has a long history with my channel. He got me to record my first video of my son Dylan and taught me how to put things up online. And then when I started my YouTube channel, Shane gave me the three most important words: just keep uploading. So Shane, let's talk about the lyrics.
Let's talk about the first verse, for example. You know, when will these clouds all disappear? I mean, that's something, this song was written in what, 1973?
Yep.
It's relatable. I was married at a young age. I had kids at a young age, 21, 22. And I mean, that's something everybody's thinking. Like, you know, when you're going through something, when is this going to end? With no loving in our soul and no money in our coats. With no loving in our souls, no money in our coats. I mean, that's something that hits home with so many people. That's why it's a timeless song.
Another thing I want to bring up are the type of piano fills that Nicky Hopkins played, because that really, to me, is an important part to what makes this song great. And to do that, I'm going to bring in Mr. Les Hall to play this while I talk about it. I'm going to play you the first phrase here in the verse. Okay, so right off the bat, we have this A minor chord with the...
All about the nine.
All about the nine, the add nines, right? And then when it goes to the E chord...
Get the same thing there, and then you also get a seven in there at times. But then you go to the G chord and you get the...
Yes, and then you have the sus key change. Four. Which is so... Beautiful. All the suspensions, the key change between the G and the F,
right,
is really what makes this verse. I mean, it's so... I mean, the A to the E7 is interesting already.
But that makes it, the whole thing, a whole different song, because there's a lot of, you know, 1-5 devices, with the minor being the one. But when you add the other guys in there, it gives it a completely unique sound.
Yeah, because the A minor, and then you get you have A minor, then E over G sharp, but then you have G major right after it.
Right.
And G major, you've lost the G sharp.
Yep.
And then you got F major with the sus.
That's a nice sus for
it. Exactly. With a B flat in it. So you have all these accidentals, all this chromaticism in there. The melody is a perfect melody.
Beautiful perfect song. Melody.
Beautiful.
Absolutely.
Song. After we go through the verse, then we get into this. That's actually the pre-chorus. Angie is the chorus when he says that.
Exactly.
So this pre-chorus then goes to G.
With a lot of sixth intervals in the right hand.
You... Another thing that's great about the song is Charlie Watts' drumming. Now, normally Charlie plays the backbeat on the snare without hitting the hi-hat. But in this song, he's actually, with no lovin', not souls. He's actually playing the hi-hat at the same time. The kick pattern is very simple. A lot of single kicks in the song, mostly single kicks like that. So it doesn't distract at all from the song, and it's very, very understated, but it sounds huge. This next phrase here. Right here. I love that, the continuation of that. You're beautiful. Yeah. He actually never stops that line. He said, beautiful, yeah. And then. I love that the vocal is not overcompressed. It has a lot of dynamic range to it, because the intimacy of that comes out when it's not all squished. Vocals that you hear today on the radio or on Spotify or wherever you listen to it, vocals, I mean, of the last 20 years or so, they get so squished that there's really no intimacy in them by limiting that dynamic range. But here, it's totally natural. Listen on. Andy, bass. I still love you. A lot of really subtle bass lines in there, a lot of moves. It's not as simple as you think it is. Bill Wyman was a great bass player, and this is a perfect blend of the bass and drums. The bass is moving just enough. It's not static. There's a lot of high notes. And you have the walking line then. And those fills, and Nicky Hopkins. Okay, now one of my favorite parts right here. Angie. So good. Angie. Come on. Who does that? And he actually whispers. The string swell into the piano solo. That's beautiful. That string swell right there. Nobody whispers. It's incredible. When the strings enter there, they do that natural swell, and those swells bring you into the next section, which is the piano solo. During the piano solo, we have the beautiful string arrangement by Nick Harrison that it starts earlier in the song but takes prominence there, especially in this part. Comes in on that B note. What's beautiful about it is that you hear on the A minor chord is that it's the ninth of the chord once again that gives it that tension, and then it, when it resolves into the E7 chord, you hear that inversion. And then it goes up to the D there, to the seventh. And that's what gives it that beautiful, beautiful warmth. So after the piano solo, we come back to the pre-chorus. Love it. And the chorus. And then we have the strings again for the solo. Then. So simple. Pre-chorus.
So we're going pre-chorus, chorus, solo, back to the pre-chorus. Then bridge. I love it. D minor, A minor. This is a great line right here. There ain't a woman that comes close to you. Come on, baby, dry your eyes. Oh, yeah. Beautiful. And then. Oh. Ain't it good to be alive? And then. Beautiful. And then. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're a first-time subscriber, remember to ring the bell. If you're interested in the Beato book, you can go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. That has things like mugs and t-shirts and things you can buy to support the channel. Follow me on Instagram. I do a lot of different stuff there at rickbeato1. And if you want to support the channel even more, become a member of the Beato Club. Thanks so much for watching. Thank you.